stopped by the Statue of Liberty, holding high her torch of freedom. We've been up 102 stories of the Empire State Building. But now, guys, here we are in front of a most famous house, a kind of crazy house made of stone. Not stone as in rock stone, stone as in... Let me tell you, we call New York the Big Apple, but this is a stone of a pig, a giant
peach.
You got it, a giant peach. Home of a real cool guy I know you want to meet. His name is?
James.
You got it again, James. James Henry Clark. Let's see if he's home. It's James. Hi, James.
Good afternoon. Hello?
Hi.
All right, I'll let you take it away, James. See you later, guys.
Thank you for coming. It's good to see you. Now, you may be wondering why an ordinary boy from England should be living in this funny, this amazing house in Central Park, New York. I've written all of my adventures in a book, this book. I'd like to tell you my story. With help, my friends, they live here with me. Would you like to meet them?
Yes!
First, there's an old green grasshopper. His music is tonic.
Now I play violin in the New York Philharmonic.
Next, there's the ladybug. Clothes are not the fashion.
I work on Fifth Avenue. I'm very big in fashion.
Now please meet the earthworm. His skin's so soft, he advertises face creams.
In commercials on TV.
It's time to greet Miss Spider. She spins the finest thread.
Now I'm on a factory making melts for ships instead.
Finally, there's Centipede, a business tycoon goose.
Vice President in charge of sales of high class boots and shoes.
It won't have escaped your attention that all my friends are insects, but you may be wondering why they are
such very large insects.
Giant insects. All will come clear as we tell you our story. It's called
James and the Giant Peach.
My teddy?
Well, you won't need that. No teddies, no toys.
work.
Yes, peel the floor and polish the spuds.
Make the dishes and wash the beds.
Now!
Aunt Sponge was terrifically fat.
And tremendously flabby at that.
Her Tommy and waist.
Her Tommy and space.
It was worse on the place where she sat.
Aunt Spiker was thin as a wire.
And dry as a bone, only drier.
And so long and thin.
If you carried her in, you could use her for poking the fire.
3 whole years went by. James worked and worked and worked and waited hand and foot on his aunts who never said please and never said thank you. He had no friends, he played no games.
Aunt's gonna call me old peach tree?
No!
Aunt's gonna go on a picnic?
Certainly not!
Aunt's gonna have a book to look at?
Of course you can't! Books only give you ideas!
One day, James was down in the garden, gazing wistfully at the forbidden world of woods and ocean and fields that spread out below him like a magic carpet.
James! What are you doing?
Nothing, Aunt.
Nothing? How dare you do nothing?
You lazy little lumbug!
Laziness?
Do something!
Chop some wood for the kitchen stove!
But it's hot.
Hot?
What rot?
I'm deliciously cool.
And I'm coolly delicious.
Because I get all the work.
I beg your pardon!
I'll get on with my work.
Go on then! Chop, chop!
Very good, Sponge dear. Chop, chop!
Good, James! Chop! Or we'll lock you in the cellar for a fortnight.
With all the other rats.
Scabby little rat. Ugly little brute.
How fortunate he is to have such an attractive aunt.
Yes, thank you, Spike dear.
Not you, Spiker dear. Moi, toi, moi. I look and smell.
Not Sponge Declare.
As lovely as a rose. Just feast your eyes upon my face. Observe my shapely nose. Behold my heavenly silky locks. And if I take off both my socks, you'll see my dainty toes. But don't forget,
Aunt Spiker said,
how much your tummy shows. James, chop faster.
Aunt Sponge went red, Aunt Spiker said,
my sweet, you cannot win. Behold my gorgeous curvy shape, my teeth, my charming grin. Oh, beautatious me, how you adore my heavenly looks. But please ignore the pimple on my chin.
My dear old trout,
Aunt Sponge cried out,
your only bones and skin. James, chop faster!
Such loveliness as I possess can only truly shine in Hollywood.
Aunt Sponge said,
oh, wouldn't that be fine? I capture all the nation's hearts. They give me all the leading parts. Stars would all resign.
I think you make,
Aunt Spiker cried,
a lovely Frankenstein. You slay me, you dunghill skinny scumbag.
You pudgy pig splatter.
You! What's the matter with you?
Get on with your work.
You lazy, good-for-nothing grim. You disgusting little worm.
Oh, Auntie Sponge and Aunt Spiker, couldn't we all, just for once, go down to the beach on a bus? It isn't very far, and I feel so hot and awful and lonely.
How dare you, ungrateful little wretch. Beat him.
I most certainly will.
I shall beat him later when I'm at full strength. Now get out of our sight
and give us some peace.
It was at this point in our story that something rather peculiar happened. Something that led to many more even peculiar things happening. Magical and incredible things.
You know, inside is the little bag. tiny green things. See them sparkle. Listen to them moving, stirring. Thousands of them. There's more magic, more power in them than in all the rest of the world put together.
What are they?
Guess. Crocodile tongues. 1,000 long, slimy crocodile tongues boiled in the skull of a dead witch for 20 days and nights with the eyeballs of a lizard. Add the fingers of a monkey, the gizzard of a pig, the beak of a young parrot, the juice of a porcupine, and 3 spoonfuls of sugar. Stew for another week, then let the moon do the rest.
Wow.
They're for you. Listen. Marvelous things, marvelous things. Put them in water just before bed. Add 10 hairs from the top of your head. Back at some going, they'll bubble and froth. And drink down the lot, trying hard not to cough. Marvelous things. While you are sleeping, they'll do their thing. When you awake, you'll feel grand again. Marvelous things will dissolve all the pain, and never will you be unhappy again. Marvelous magical things. What marvelous things it can do is marvelous magical things to make marvelous things happen to you.
Thank you.
Now off you go, my dear. And not a word, not a whisper of this to those horrible aunts of yours. Now's the time. Hurry. And James, look after those marvelous things. If they escape, they'll be working the magic on somebody else. Whoever they meet first, be it bug, insect, animal, or tree. Magic power will work on them, whoever they may be. Now go, good fortune be yours.
Thank you.
the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Shut up, you little twerp. It's none of your business. It's our peach. Now make a show. I want to get stuck in.
Wait. Not yet.
Why not? My tummy's all a rumble.
Listen. If we played this right, we could be millionaires.
Thank you.
food.
Please, I...
What's the matter, dear fellow? You look positively ill.
You're not going to be sick, are you?
Oh, the poor thing. I do believe he thinks it's him we want to eat.
Oh, dear.
Perish the thought.
You don't fancy a bite of James. It is James, isn't it?
Yes.
I'm a spider. You can shake one of my legs if you'd like.
Thank you.
You mustn't be frightened, James. We wouldn't dream of hurting you. You're one of us now. We're all in this together.
We thought you'd never show up. We're delighted to see you. So cheer up, sunshine. Smile.
Oh, yeah! What's he got to smile about, huh? I've got nothing to smile about!
I'll take no notice of Bertram. He's always miserable.
Just come up here and sit by me, James.
You have a lot of wounds.
There's a reason for that. Ask me. Go on.
Why do you have a lot of wounds?
I am glad you asked me. I have a lot of boots because, well, I have a lot of legs, and a whole lot of feet, 100 to be exact. You see, I'm a centipede.
Oh, yeah, there he goes again. Lies. You've got nowhere near a 100 legs. 42, that's all you've got. You count. Besides, there's nothing wrong with having lots of legs anyways.
Poor old soul, James. He's blind. Can't see anything we do, or how marvelous I look.
What? The really marvelous thing is having no legs at all and being able to walk just the same.
You call that walking? You're a slither and that's all you are. All you do is just slither along.
Pardon me, sir, but I walk.
You're a slimy beast.
How dare you?
Boys, James doesn't want to hear you arguing.
I am a very useful and much loved creature. Ask any gardener. As for you,
I'm a pest.
He's so proud of that.
I am the only pest on this peach. It doesn't count over your grasshopper, but he's old. Like, way past proper pest status.
Young fellow, I am not and have never been a pest. I am a musician.
Hear, hear!
Years of practice have gotten me to the point where I don't even have to strum on the beat.
Lost me bitten by phosphate!
Chalk's away, guys.
We're off.
Hold on.
Beach roll.
Help.
Right. We're floating beautifully. We must all remain.
be perfectly calm. Everything will be all right in the end.
Ha! Famous last words. Nothing's ever all right in the end.
Don't listen to him. He's only ever happy when he's miserable.
I suppose just being an earthworm is enough to make anyone miserable.
Hey! I heard that!
Good. Settle down, everyone. So remain perfectly calm. Let me play you a relaxing note. A flaw, an error, a conundrum, if you will. How do you propose?
Yeah, you can't expect them just to fly down and stick their heads in a loop.
We use bait.
Bait? What sort of bait?
Worms. Seagulls love worms.
I am not hearing this!
And lucky for us, we have the biggest, fattest, pinkest, juiciest earthworm in the world.
You can stop right there!
No, James, don't stop. Go on. I like it. I like really like it.
Well, I don't like it! I can be pecked at it.
Don't mind your own business and be clinically depressed somewhere else.
Excuse me! This is more my business than it is yours! I refuse.
You won't die, earthworm. I promise. All you do is stick your head out of the tunnel.
Uh-huh, and where will you be, James?
Hidden in the tunnel.
I knew it! I knew it!
We have to get into the tunnel, or the seagulls won't dare fly down. So you're poking out.
I'll suck it with attempting.
Stop it!
A seagull flies down.
We should probably hurry. The sharks are back.
Right, quick, everyone.
No! God, really darn dang it!
Come on, seagulls.
Moving. Yes. giant ladybug.
Now just a minute, Captain.
Are you feeling quite yourself today, Captain?
And a colossal green grasshopper.
Captain, please.
And a mammoth spider.
Don't you think it's best if you better have a lie down, Captain?
And an enormous, a simply enormous centipede. What do you think, number one?
I think Captain's found the whiskey again.
What do you think, number two?
Well, I think we should get Captain the ship's dog quick.
Thank you.
boots are ruined by the water. All 50 pairs.
Oh, shut up. You only have 21. Plus, you're lucky to be alive.
I guess I am. Poor little rascal. Thank you, James.
Yet again, James has saved the day. A remarkable boy, indeed. Soon, night began to fall. The next morning, we were all enjoying our breakfast in peace, usually. And suddenly, out of the blue,
there's land ahead. You guys, come over here. There's land ahead. Except for you, you're blind.
Fascinating, glistening in the early morning sunshine.
Tiny streets and houses,
and lots of little wheels crawling along.
I think you'll find that those are cars, I think.
They are cars, and people the size of grains of sand.
Just shows how high we're flying.
Some of the buildings look very tall.
I think they're skyscrapers. We must be in America.
America? You mean we crossed the Atlantic?
Not a peach. Brilliant.
Amazing.
Incredible.
I've always dreamed of going to America.
Well, now's your chance, you boy. Well, as long as you don't fly right over it, how do you suggest we get down?
Centipede, nibble a few threads, call us a few seagulls.
I got it. James, you're a genius.
What's that noise?
It's getting louder.
Oh no, it's an airplane.
It's coming this way. Look out.
Well, I guess that's the end of my life. Thanks for coming today. It's good to see you. Safe journey home, and goodbye from
James and the Giant Peach!